Dr. Joanne Sotelo joins us from Baylor Scott & White Medical Center in Round Rock. So we've heard a lot of people say that you've got to be very careful spending too much time in the sun because of the damage it can have on your eyes and your skin. But there's got to be some positives from spending time in the sunshine too, right?
It's good that we've heard the message of be careful with the sun, right, and all the negative implications that it has. But then we also have to remember that we need the good vitamin D that our body produces from the sun, mainly. Our bodies need vitamin D to function well, our heart, our bones. One of the main things that we know that it helps with is that it helps us absorb calcium and phosphorus, and we need that for our bones and for our immune system. We can also get it from some foods like fatty fish and fortified milk and yogurt, or we can get it from supplements. Right? I think that we also have the false idea, especially for those of us who live in sunny places like Texas, that then we don't, like, we're good. We get plenty of sun. But you'll be surprised of how many people are vitamin D deficient. And as a psychiatrist, that's one of the things that I screen for, because low levels of vitamin D can mimic and cause depression. So it's more important than what we think.
How much should we be spending outside, say, on a daily basis?
Like, if you think of being out in the sun just to get, like, your skin burned or a tan, it's less than half of that time. So that's important to know. It's not about being in the sun until your skin color changes. Someone with a lighter skin does not need to be in the sun out as long as someone with darker skin to get that good sun absorption.